Good morning, everybody. Hope you enjoyed yesterday's class, Mr. Chandrakant on science. And day before yesterday, Naveen Kumar has presented a beautiful clipping on English. And today, we have one more experienced teacher with us. Mr. Halesh is here. You are very, very lucky to have the presence of Halesh here. When I asked him to present some topics on mathematics to support our children, he has come forward, he has extended his helping hand to our KRCS. Now he is with us to give you the first topic of mathematics in class 10th. I welcome on behalf of KRCS, Mr. Halesh. Please come on the dais. Yes, Halesh sir is there. How are you, sir?
Sir, I'm fine, sir.
How do you feel to present online lesson for the children?
Sir, actually we are in critical situation, so that we can't do any classes within the school.
Yeah.
So it's time to switch over to technology based learning.
Yes.
So that is what you came forward to do, like these classes.
Instead of wasting their valuable time, they can make use of it.
They can make use of it, and suppose if we give couple of topics so that they can go through the topics before they come to the school. This is good tendency, so that we can nurture our students in technology.
Yes. Thank you so much, sir. Carry on with us. And once again, I thank you for your valuable presence. Please
thank
go
you,
ahead.
Sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Hello, everyone. I hope whether it is required or not, you might have enjoying the privilege of holidays, but somewhat it's time to switch over to academics. That is the reason behind principal sir came forward to do this online classes and all by doing this one channel in YouTube. So today, without wasting the time, so let's we go through the topic in mathematics. Dear children, what you learned in 9th standard, let's we continue the same thing here also. So see, like some concepts what you learned in 9th standard, that will be continued in 10th standard also. Say for example, number system you learned, its continued part real number is there. Similarly, you learned polynomials in 9th standard, it is also continued part is there. So let's we learn the concepts which are important as far as the CBSE board exams are concerned. Okay, so let's we go to one topic, that is polynomials. Okay, dear children, in 9th standard itself you learned what is the meaning of polynomial and what will be the types of polynomials. So polynomials, basically we will go through simple definition, that's it. Polynomials are particular types of algebraic expression which consists of numbers and variables in which degrees of variables are non-negative. So if you go through the examples of polynomials, if you write down as x plus 1, it is a polynomial. And if you write down as x square minus 4, it is also a polynomial. And if you write down 2x square plus 5x plus 6, it is also a polynomial. So like these things you learnt in 9th standard. And depend upon the degrees of variables, we have classification of polynomials. So if we go through the classification of polynomials, first one it is, first type of polynomial, it is linear polynomial. Linear means a polynomial of degree 1, which is called as linear polynomial. Example, just record this one, x plus 1, the degree of this variable it is 1. That's why you can say that it is a linear. You can give any example, for this question, the degree of variable it is 1. Similarly, x minus 9, it is also a linear polynomial. Like that, we can give so many ample of examples, that is enough. Next one, quadratic. quadratic. Quadra means degree of variable, it is 2. Say for example, just look out this one, x square minus 4, we can consider this one as the type of quadratic polynomial. Similarly, x square plus 5x plus 6 is also a quadratic polynomial. Next one, if we go through next one, it is cubic polynomial. As the word itself describes, the type that is cubic means degree of variable it will be 3. Say for example, we can write down as x cube minus 27, and even if you write down as x cube also, it is a cubic polynomial. Next up, one more is there, that is biquadratic polynomial. Again, biquadratic means the degree of variable it will be 4. That is, we can say that it is a biquadratic polynomial. Say for example, x to the power of 4 minus 64, x to the power of 4 plus 9x square plus 6x plus 5. It is also, we can say that it is a biquadratic polynomial. So, this is what classification of polynomials depend upon the degrees of variables. This first one, linear polynomial, where the degree of variable it is 1, and then quadratic polynomial, where the degree of variable it is 2, and then cubic polynomial, the degree of variable it is 3, and then biquadratic polynomial means its degree of variable it is 4. Okay. Suppose if we go through the standard form of all these, so standard form of linear polynomial is given by plus b. This is the standard form of linear polynomial, that is p of x is equal to ax plus b. Next, if we go through quadratic polynomial, standard form it is given by p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Next, if we go through the standard form of cubic polynomial, it is ax cube plus bn square plus cx plus d. Similarly, if you go through the standard form of biquadratic polynomial, ax to the power of 4 plus bx cube plus cx square plus bx plus d. This is the standard form of biquadratic polynomial. Okay, this is enough. Now let's we learn what is the meaning of biquadratic polynomial and what is the meaning of factorization. Okay, I think that is enough. Already all these things you learnt in 9th standard only. As far as exam, CBSE board exam concerned, as far as 10th standard CBSE board exam concerned, we will be having two important concepts in polynomials. We will discuss only these two things. So first one, relation between zeros of a polynomial and its coefficients. This is the first important topic. And then second one, division algorithm of are the two topics that is comprises when it comes to polynomial. That is first one, a relation between zeros of a polynomial and its coefficients, and the second one, division algorithm of polynomials. So you learnt when it comes to linear polynomial, there exists only one zero for that particular polynomial. When it comes to quadratic polynomial, since its highest degree is 2, there exist two zeros, or we can say that there exist two factors. Same meanwhile, like that only cubic polynomial, when it comes to cubic polynomial, its highest degree is 3, there exist 3 zeros. Like that only it will be continued. By quadratic polynomial means its degree is 4, means there exist 4 zeros. So based on that one, let's we learn what will be the relation between zeros of a polynomial and its coefficients. Say for example, let's we take example of quadratic polynomial. So the standard form of quadratic polynomial is given by x square plus bx plus c. Here x square and x, they represent the variables that is present in that particular polynomial. A is coefficient of x square, b is coefficient of x, and then c means it is constant. Okay, this is what. Here its meaning is a is the coefficient of x square, b means coefficient of x, and then c is constant. That is what I am telling you now. There exists a close relation between coefficients of quadratic polynomial as well as zeros. We will learn what will be the relation between zeros and coefficients of the given polynomial. You already learned. Let's take one example. Polynomial x, x square plus 5x plus c. This is the quadratic polynomial. So you learned, since it is a quadratic polynomial, there exist two zeros. How to find out two zeros of this quadratic polynomial? Okay. So you learned one thing, that is what? We can find out two zeros of this quadratic polynomial by splitting it. Say for example, what will be the constant here? 6. Here, first term is x square. First we multiply these two, 6 into x square, 6 square. Now next we try to find out the factors of 6x square or 6 in such a way that if we multiply, we have to get 6. If we do addition or subtraction, we have to get the middle term, that is 5. So factors of 6. So means if you go through in what and all tables, it will come 6. Say for example, 2, 3 is a 6. 2 plus 3, it will come give 5. So we can split out 6x square as 2x and then 3. So what happens here? 2x into 3x means it will give the product of x square into constant, that is 2, 3 is a 6, x into x square. If I add these two factors, 2x and then 3x, it will be 5x. So means we can split this 5x as 2x and then 3x. Since we doesn't have a minus sign, so we will straight away take these two as plus 1. So x square plus 5x plus 6. See, we are going to split the middle term as 2x plus 3x plus 6 is equal to 0, because we are going to find out zeros of this quadratic polynomial. So I have split it. We have just look out, we can work out in different way also. I am just giving one option, that's it. 2, 3 is a 6, 2x plus 3x means it is 5x. This is what splitting it. Now let us we group these two as binomials. Here LCF of x square and x is x. What is left out? X plus 2. Plus 3 and 6. Commonly we can divide from 3. What is left inside? X plus 3, 2 is a 6. 3, 2 is a 6. So I took out 3 outside. What is left out inside? It is x plus 2. When you work out the splitting method of quadratic polynomial, make sure the binomial what you got, it will be common. Then only what you done, it is right. If you get different one means you might have done wrong. Okay. So in this expression, what is common here? X plus 2 is common. What is left inside? It is x plus 3 is equal to 0. Nothing but x plus 2 is equal to 0, or x
this x plus 2 and x plus 3, we call them as the factors of this dual quadratic polynomial. That is only if we write down in terms of variable, they will become 0. That is x2 if we transform means x2, and another one means x equal to plus 3 becomes minus 3.
So, as I already informed, when it comes to quadratic polynomial, there exists 2 zeros. So here I got 2 zeros, that is one is minus 2 and then minus 3. So the zeros of that particular polynomial, they will be named by one symbols, that is one of the zeros will be take it as alpha and another zero will be take it as beta. These two zeros we will indicate, we will represent in terms of symbols, that is alpha and then beta. We will take anyone, you can take it as alpha, anyone you can take it as beta. That is alpha is minus 2 and beta is minus 3. So now just look out here, what I have done. First thing, we are going to learn the relation between zeros of a polynomial and its coefficients. Here only I try to find out only zeros of this, what I took out the example of the polynomial. Okay. Now we have to identify the relation. No? So what is the relation we will look out? Okay. I will rub this one. Just look out carefully. Zeros of the quadratic polynomial we indicate by two things, that is what, alpha plus beta. What is this meaning? Plus I have written means sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta is equal to minus of coefficient of x square divided by coefficient of coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Okay. And we have another relation, alpha into beta, that is constant term. Of one particular polynomial. Okay. What will be the condition? Rule says that sum of two zeros is always is equal to minus of what will be the coefficient of x? B. This is the coefficient of x, that is b divided by. What is coefficient of x square here? This is the standard form, general form. Here the coefficient of x square and coefficient of x and constant term may be indicated by ABC, where A, B and C, they are real numbers, right? That is the reason why coefficient of x means B, that is minus of B divided by coefficient of x square means it is A. So first rule is sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus B by A. And then product of zeros, that is alpha into beta is equal to constant term. Constant term means C divided by coefficient of x square means A. This is C by A. Okay. This is the relation between zeros. This is the relation between zeros of a polynomial. Look out here. I already informed zeros of polynomial we indicated as alpha and beta.
And of course, A, B, C, they are all the coefficient, the real numbers which is present in this quadratic polynomial. So as per the rule, sum of zeros is always is equal to minus P by A. And product of zeros is always is equal to C by A. That is alpha plus beta is equal to minus of coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Alpha into beta is equal to constant term divided by coefficient of x square. We have to verify now. Let's we try to verify. We will take this example. Okay. In this case, in this polynomial, x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic polynomial, right? Here, we will compare this quadratic polynomial with standard form. Here, A means coefficient of x square, right? Here also, here we doesn't have anything here. We doesn't have anything with x square means we assume that there is this one, coefficient of x square is 1. Next, B is equal to coefficient of x is 5. C, constant term is 6. Okay? Next, we have already find out the zeros of this polynomial. What is that one? Alpha and beta, that is 2 zeros are minus 2 minus 3. So we will take it as alpha is minus 2 and then beta is equal to minus 3. Now let's try to verify rule alpha plus beta is equal to what I wrote is equal to minus b by a. Alpha means what? Minus 2 plus beta means minus 3 is equal to minus. This minus, it is present in rule itself, minus bracket of what is b here, 5 divided by a, what is coefficient of x square, 1, minus 2 plus of minus minus 3 is equal to minus 5 divided by 1 means 5 1 minus 5 only, minus 5 minus 3. Two terms, they have like sign is there, means plus and plus, minus and minus means we will do addition. Minus 2 and minus 3 if you add means it will become minus 5 is equal to minus 5. So you can see we got LHS is equal to RHS. LHS is equal to RHS. That is what we verified the rule, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. We have to verify one more condition. What is that one? Alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Again, what is alpha here? Minus 2. It doesn't have any sign, yes, assume that there is multiplication. Into beta means minus 3 is equal to. What is constant here? Silico. 6, constant is 6 divided by a means. When we multiply minus and minus into minus means plus 2, 3 is 6. 6 divided by 1 means 1 we will neglect, 6 divided by 1 means 6 only, here also we will neglect that 6 is equal to 6. So means this is the relation holds good for any quadratic polynomial if there exist zeros for that particular quadratic polynomial. That is what alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Okay. We will take one more example and then we will go for second concept. Only this example, then we will go for next concept. So x square minus 2x minus 8. Of course, it is a quadratic polynomial. So now we have to verify the relation between zeros and its coefficients, right? First, let's we try to find out what will be the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. Then we can look out what will be the relation. Again, what is first step here? First, we will multiply x square first term with constant. X square into minus 8, what happens? Minus 8, 8x square. when it comes to minus sign, we should be very careful when we have to take plus sign, when we have to take minus sign. 8. Just for it about x square, 8. What will be the factors of 8? Meaning, in what and all tables it become 8? Say for example, 1 8 is 8, 2 4 is 8. So we can take 2 4 is 8 or 8 1 is 8. See, suppose if I take 2x and then 4x. 2 4 is 8, x into x, x square. But the question is, here it consists of minus, here also minus. When the middle term consists of minus sign, means greater number we have to take minus sign, smaller number we have to take plus sign. So what happens here? See, look out. Plus 2x into minus 4x is equal to plus into minus minus 2 fourths of 8x. Next, suppose from minus 4, if we subtract plus 2, what will get? Minus 2, where that will be the middle term. So it can be split as x square plus 2x minus 4x minus 8 is equal to 0. See, look at 2 4 is 8 plus into minus minus. From minus 4x, if we subtract plus 2x, we will get minus 2x. So this is how we can split. Okay. We doesn't have any bounded rule or condition like first only we have to write 2x and next we have to write down 4x. We don't have like that. You can write down minus 4x plus and 2x later. Like that also you can write down, but we can split out that. Okay, now let's see split out this. First we will group them as binomials. We can take x outside. What is left out? X plus 2. Minus, compulsory we have to write down the sign, minus. For 4 and 8, HCF is 4. What is left out here? X. Look out. For minus, we have to multiply plus, then only we get minus. Minus into plus, minus. 4, 2 is 8 is equal to 0. See, here we got the same by now. So, x plus 2, it is common. What is left inside? X minus 4 is equal to 0. Nothing but x plus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0. X is equal to minus 2, or because if you transfer x, it will become minus 2, or x is equal to minus 4 become plus 4. So two zeros of this quadratic polynomial is given by alpha is equal to 1 0, I will consider as alpha, and another 0 I will consider as beta, that is 4. So, we got the two zeros of this particular quadratic polynomial, that is x square minus 2x minus 8, that is two zeros are minus 2 and 4. Now, we have to establish the relation between these two now. So, if we go through the given polynomial x square minus 2x is equal to 0. Here what is a? Coefficient of x square is 1. And what is b? Coefficient of x is minus 2. What is constant term? It is minus. And two zeros of this polynomial is given by alpha is minus 2 and then beta is equal to 4. As I already discussed, the relation is like this, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Look out here, alpha means minus 2 plus beta means 4 is equal to minus b. B means minus 2. See, you might have confused why I have written minus sign two times. See, in rule itself it consists of minus sign. B means it is minus 2 divided by A means coefficient of x square is 1. See, when it they consists of opposite sign, minus 2 and plus 4 means when the numbers they consists of opposite sign, of course we have to do subtraction and we have to place the greater number sign. So greater number sign is plus, plus 4 minus 2 means 2, minus half minus becomes plus, 2 divided by minus 2. See, we start this question, that is LHS is equal to RHS. Similarly, we have to verify one more rule, alpha into beta is equal to C by A. Alpha means minus 2 into beta means 4 is equal to, what is C here? Minus 8 divided by A means 1. Minus 2 into 4, what happens? We become minus 8 is equal to minus 8 divided by 1 means it is minus 8 only. So we got LHS is equal to RHS. So this is the first concept, that is what? The relation between zeros of a polynomial and its coefficients, zero. For this polynomial, these are the two zeros and they are the coefficients of this given polynomial. And this is what the relation between zeros and its coefficients, that is what LHS is equal to RHS. The meaning is simple. When it comes to quadratic polynomial, and if you find out two zeros of that particular polynomial, sum of two zeros is always is equal to minus of coefficient of x upon coefficient of x square, that is minus b by a. And product of two zeros, that is always is equal to constant term divided by coefficient of x square, that is alpha into beta is equal to c by a. So this is the first concept. So based on that one only, you work out similar questions what will be given in your textbook. We will go for next concept. Next important one. Second concept, division algorithm for polynomials. So, division algorithm for polynomials states that any polynomial invariable P of x, when it is divided by divisor G of x, it will give the quotient Q of x plus it give the remainder R of x. Like what we learnt in real numbers, that is the division algorithm given by Euclid, same thing holds good for polynomials also. So any polynomial in x P of x is divided by g of x, it will give the quotient q of x plus remainder r of x. We will look up one example. Divide. P of x is equal to x cube minus 3m square plus 5x minus 3 by g of x is equal to x square minus 2. The question meaning is simple. You just look out the given polynomial is cubic polynomial. This cubic polynomial we have to divide from the quadratic polynomial x square minus 2 and we have to find out what will be the quotient and what will be the remainder. Let's we go through this one. Okay. So here this is the dividend, this is the divisor. So like normal division only we will write down x square minus 2. We are going to divide from this one. Which one? X cube minus 3x square plus 5x minus 3. So, dear children, you just keep it in your mind. When it comes to division of numbers, it is different.
And when it comes to division algorithm of polynomials, it is different. Here in division algorithm of polynomials, what we will do, we will step by step, we will terminate the terms of the polynomials so that we will get quotient and then remainder. So you just look out, if I want to terminate first term of this polynomial x cube, here also I have to get x cube. How to get that one? See, what we will do, first we have to look out whether they are the standard form or not. Standard form of polynomials means they should be in the form of decreasing powers of variables, and last it should be constant. Look out, here polynomial it will be in the form of decreasing powers of variables, last it is constant, even divisor also. What we will do, first term of the polynomial x cube, we will divide from first term of the divisor square. Here we have 2x's, here we have 3x's, 2x, 2x cancel one term to x. That we will return in quotient part, and this x we will multiply with these two terms. X into x square, what happens? X cube plus into minus minus x into 2, what happens? It will become, see, look out. I have multiplied x square into x, it will give x cube. When we multiply x with 2, plus into minus, it will become minus 2 into x, 2x. But here it consists of 3x square. So when we write down this 2x, it should be below the same writer. So where we have to write down minus 2 into x, 2x. I wrote below 5x. The reason behind their degrees are same. I have not written it. Okay, I will just please keep it in your mind. So of course in division, normal division also we will do subtraction. Here also we have to do subtraction. At that time what happens, sign will be changed. Here the sign is plus, it will be converted into minus. Plus x cube cancelled. Here minus is there, it will become into plus. So here minus 3x square is there, I will write down as it is. Plus 5x, now if the new sign is plus 2x, it will become plus 7x. Minus 3. First term. Next term. Minus 3x square, we will divide from x square. X square cancel one left out, minus 3. So minus 3 we will take it as quotient. Now we just very carefully just look out. This 3 we have to multiply with these two terms of the divisor. So means including minus. Minus into plus minus 3 into x square, 3x square. Next one. 3 minus into minus plus 3 2s are 6. Here also, where we have to write down minus into minus plus 3 to the 6, because we will get constant, that is the reason why we have to write down the below constant only. So what we do? Your sign will be plus 6 will be plus, minus 3x square plus 3x square get cancelled. Here what is left out? So then x, here it will become 7 minus, minus 3 and minus 6 it will become minus 9. Further, we can't continue the division algorithm. I will tell you why. The reason here. When the remainder, degree of variable in the remainder, it will become less than the degree of variable of divisor, we can't continue the division algorithm. We have to stop there. I will repeat once again. Here in remainder, degree of variable is less than the degree of variable in divisor. So we can't continue. So when we divide this polynomial from x square minus 2, we got the quotient as x minus 3 and remainder as 7x minus 9. So this is what the division algorithm. Okay, thank you children. Rest of the things we will continue in next class. Thank you, have a nice day.